Alright guys, Ivan here with another video, and in this video you're gonna watch Brandon Curry's transformation that he was able to make in the last 3 years. So only 3 years, that's right. This picture on the left is him at Arnold Classic Europe 2016, and the one on the right is 2019 Arnold Classic, which you may recognize because it truly is an amazing package. One of the best packages of bodybuilders, I would say, in the last 10 years. I was really amazed, to be honest. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I think he received an award for the most improved bodybuilder in 2018. And I don't want to waste any more of your precious time. Let's start with this video and let's watch three posing routines of him in 2016 and in 2019. And let's compare. Let's see what kind of improvements was he actually able to make. Alright, so first he's gonna be hitting front double bicep. And as you can see, looks pretty good, but he's kind of small. And I think it's very impressive that he was able to make such transformation at such a high level. You know, that's really impressive. When guys at that level, they don't really put a lot of muscle in the year. It's really, I mean, he's a pro. But look at what he was able to make. So let's go with 2019 now. And boom. Damn. Look at those arms. Look at them and admire them. Look at the legs, the fullness of his whole body. It's just so impressive. So impressive. How did he do it? I don't know, it's camel crew technology, I can only assume. What are they doing there, but what kind of anabolic chicken do they have? God only knows, but yeah. Definitely huge improvement as far as muscle fullness, conditioning, completeness, and posing as well. Look at the posing, he definitely improved his posing. Now we're gonna see his side chest pose. You know, it's good, but it's not what it is right now. So let's take a look at what he's packing right now. And dearie me, look at this. Wow. Huge, huge, huge bodybuilder. He packed a lot of mass on his hamstrings and overall legs and the chest and the arms in only 3 years. I don't know, this is just amazing, amazing. Let's proceed to the next pose. So we come to the back double bicep, in my opinion, the most important pose in bodybuilding. So let's see. All right. I mean, conditioning is okay. He could have had a bit more shredded glutes and hamstrings, but it's pretty good. But he's kind of small, you know, to be contender at the Mr. Olympia, for example. But let's see what he's hip packing right now. And oh my god, it's already impressive. Yeah, his legs are a bit smaller, but I think they actually make his back even bigger. Those lats are super thick. I don't think any of the pros in that level right now has lats this thick. Not Sean Roden, not Rolly Winkler. Nobody, pretty much. Nobody, pretty much, I would say. So yeah, he's packing some serious mass with some serious conditioning nowadays. And let's go with the next pose of 2016. That's gonna be back lat spread. And okay, here is what he's having. Not bad, not bad. Let's see what does he have now. And again, pay attention to his posing. Right now it's much more elegant, much more firm. Oh my god. Oh my god, those lats are really impressive. I haven't even noticed this before, seriously, before I watched this video, but look at the lats. Lats are thick as hell. Damn. This is new Dorian Yates, guys. This back is really, really impressive. Honestly, I would be really, really surprised if he doesn't win this year's Mr. Olympia. And next video is going to be about that. I'm going to compare him to next to Sean Roden to see actually, can this version of Brandon Curry win against Sean Roden? And I think it can. I think it's possible because this is just really, really good, really thick, really massive, really, really big. He really made an amazing improvement, and this is like one of the most improved bodybuilders in history of bodybuilding. Like, this is comparable to the 1993 version of Dorian Yates compared to 1992. So this is something like that. It's in that ballpark. Anyways, let's go with the next pose. And yeah, it's gonna be 2016 edition of his front lat spread, but it's from this angle, so you pretty much can't see anything. But you can see the shallowness of his physique. It's just not very deep. It's just not very thick from the side. And that is most certainly not the case anymore. Because now he's packing some serious, serious mass with some crazy conditioning. You know that his legs are his weakness. But in this pose, he's kind of showing his inner thighs. And they're making his legs look very, very thick. So definitely his legs are looking much, much fuller and bigger. And he also, he's showing amazing lat development, chest is on point, arms are there, shoulders, the definition, I mean, conditioning, amazing, amazing, very, very narrow waist. This is top notch. This is top notch. And I'm telling you, this is your next Mr. Olympia. Mark my words. Let's proceed to 2016. Actually, let's rewind back to 2016. And you can see this kind of variation of a pose, something he likes to do in his reposing routines. So basically kind of most muscular while kind of squatting on one leg, and I don't know how to call this, to be honest. But yeah, you can see that he's not very confident here. Definitely is not very confident, but now he is. Now he is. Let's see what he's doing now. Yeah, it's not gonna be exactly the same variation of a pose, but you can see that confidence is on a high, high level, and deservedly so. So he definitely deserves to be confident, because this is really impressive. And yeah, you can see the stomach. His abs are really, really symmetrical, and that is a rare sight to be seen at this level of bodybuilding. So yeah, I commend him for that. And let's go with actually 2016 version. Alright, there you go. Of abs and thighs. So you can see that his abs were a bit blurry, and the legs are definitely one of his biggest weaknesses. Even today, but it was very, very obvious back then. Now it's not that much. So look at it now. And can you tell that his legs are his weakness now? I don't think so. This inner part of the thighs is much, much bigger now, and yeah, that really gives a lot of size and thickness in his legs. So yeah, abs are amazing, the narrow waist is there, so that's everything is on point. Lats are flaring, amazing, amazing, huge improvement. And now you can see his addition of most muscular in 2016, not bad, but not nearly as good as it is right now. And damn, the fullness of his arms and his legs and shoulders, the shoulders are crazy on him as well. And he's actually showing proper abs, proper stomach, proper abdominal region. It's just beautiful. And traps are also popping. Everything is on point, really, from head to toe, from head to toe. So amazing bodybuilder. And this transformation is one of the most impressive transformations that I ever saw. What did he do? How did he improve? I think he's just focused. He was really, really focused on bodybuilding, and especially in Kuwait, you know how they work. They just basically live and breathe bodybuilding 24/7. It's all just about eating and training, and basically nothing else exists, just complete tunnel vision, putting those blinders on your eyes and just focusing on one thing. And if you do that, you definitely make improvements. And if you are genetically blessed like this guy, you win Arnold Classic and potentially Mr. Olympia, but we'll see about that. Anyways, tell me guys what you think about this transformation, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to like the video. If you want to see more, subscribe. And if also you want to help me, share this video to some of your friends who are also fans of bodybuilding. It would really be helpful. So thank you very much, and all the best guys. Bye bye.